Cuomo trying to defend himself by claiming he kisses everyone and showing this very bizarre and horrible picture montage.
Indeed, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of photos of me using the exact same gesture. I do it with everyone, black and white, young and old, straight and LGBTQ, powerful people, friends, strangers, people who I meet on the street.
Well, the one we didn't show you was the ones where he used President Obama and President Bush hugging hurricane victims as if that was the same thing. Jesse, it looks like you brought some thoughts.
It's pretty damning. I thought we had the worst mayor, now we have the worst governor. So these are the allegations. Kissing on the lips, grabbing butts and breasts. Asked a state trooper if she could help him find a girlfriend who could, quote, handle pain.
Love it.
Groping waists, legs, and back, sliding hands pretty much everywhere, and just relentlessly hitting on every aide that was alone with him in an elevator or his office.
Oh, man.
Now, this report was written by an AG who has aspirations politically, and it said all these women were uncomfortable, scared, humiliated, and offended.
So I hate to say it this way, Janet, but I think this story has legs.
Wow.
I mean, it's lasting more than the 24-hour news cycle. And, you know, Governor Cuomo, you know, I don't know, was he going to crawl in a hole somewhere like Ralph Northam did, you know, until...
And then emerge, try to remake himself?
Yeah.
I don't know. He's so smarmy, though.
Yeah.
But he gets away with it. And so does Northam.
Yeah. I think the PDA is going to be dialed back quite a bit.
One can only hope. I got to tell you, I got my Bam Bam hair today. It's really messing with my... with
your
my,
headphones?
With my headphones.
It's going to make the thing come down, make you look like you're calling out signals. 24, 38! Just need a helmet.
I got the face mask. I did. I threw the messy bun up on top, and it's like, you know.
So you've got quite a miracle story with your hand and Sylvadine.
Let me tell you what. I don't want to... calling it a miracle drug seems to be a bit, you know, much.
Right.
But it kind of is.
Right.
It kind of is a miracle drug.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so thankful.
For those of you that don't know, Janet burned her hand quite bad over... the last few days.
Yeah, yeah, I did it on Sunday.
And
you know, it's the worst burn I've ever had in my life, and I would argue the worst pain I've ever had. And I've had three kids,
right?
So I'm just saying. And your wife, who is a nurse practitioner,
right,
said you really need to get the Sylvadine.
Mm-hmm.
And so I did. Yeah. And oh my word,
yeah, it worked for me back in the 80s when I had a radiator explode and I got 18% of my body got the hot water on me, and I got burned, and mainly my arms, all my forearms and the inside of my arms. It didn't scar me. I got it on parts of my, you know, my chest.
I mean,
and my stomach.
Literally have another. I get lots of little burns just
right,
because I cook so much and grill and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
My hand that I use the Sylvadine on looks better than this little tiny burn.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't nearly as bad as something like this, and that's probably 3-4 weeks ago.
Okay,
and didn't have anything on it.
Right.
So it's kind of
interesting.
It's kind of miraculous.
Good stuff.
I'll be keeping that behind a little glass in
a
little
lock.
Glass frame with a little hammer in case of an emergency. Then you can break the glass and get to it. So yeah, that'll fall under the don't touch that.
Right, exactly.
Don't you be using that for just anything.
Yeah,
so it is.
Only Mama Janet's allowed to break the glass.
That's to break the glass. And I will, because typically I use aloe vera. I've got an aloe vera plant, things like that. Aloe vera did not touch this one, though.
Right.
So anyway, glad it's better.
Yeah.
I'm thankful. All right, thought of the day for this Thursday. Mm-hmm. Logic will get you from A to B, but imagination will take you anywhere.
Isn't that true?
That.
Logic will take you from A to B, but imagination will take you anywhere.
Yep.
That's good. That's like a Walt Disney quote, almost.
Yeah, almost.
Kind of. You know,
I mean, sometimes you need logic, but sometimes you need more.
Mm-hmm.
And imagination is a good thing. 434-248-0704. That's our text number. Mm-hmm. We give you that so you can join us in our Mind Jam trivia question.
Okay, so this is interesting because, you know, I come from Italian roots.
Right.
My grandparents were both full-blooded Italian. So there is a custom. So
they would probably have known the answer to this.
Yeah, this would, but I never heard it growing up. So even from my mom, who was full-blooded Italian. So there is a custom in Italy for women to wear red.
Red what?
For luck on New Year's Eve. So something they would wear that's red on New Year's Eve for luck. This is a custom in Italy for women to wear red what for luck on New Year's Eve. Sorry.
434-248-0704. What do women wear that is red on New Year's Eve for luck?
I don't think I'm giving a hint here. But as I was looking for, you know, I look on this day and we've got President Nixon coming up. I found an old video of Barbara, I call her Barbara Wawa, Barbara Walters, and she was doing the news with a red scarf with big white polka dots.
Oh.
And this was in 1975, I guess, or whatever year it is here, 74. And it just looked odd. Like, it looked like she had just come out of the kitchen or something, you know, or she almost looked Italian in the sense that you would see women back in the day wearing these red, do you call them a scarf that you put on the head? Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And some women wore them better than others.
Right.
But because they would get their hair done once a week.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
They would do that to keep their hair intact.
What do they call it? A weave? The bee hive or something, or the big thing that went up.
They would get a set in style, and sometimes they had a beehive.
Mom had the beehive occasionally.
Yeah,
it was interesting.
It was teased and sprayed within an inch of its
life.
Oh my
God, that's the truth.
All right, that's
anyway,
right. I can't imagine going through. I mean, they suffered for their femininity.
Oh, they did.
But no doubt about that. All right. Here we go. On this day in history, 1926, Harry Houdini stays in a coffin underwater for 1.5 hours before escaping. Now, how did he do that?
I don't know. I have no idea. There, 1926, there wasn't a hidden oxygen tank somewhere, I doubt.
Well, I mean, he had something going on there.
Yeah,
there's no way he did that, you know.
Maybe he calculated that thing was airtight and there was enough oxygen. I don't know.
To last that long?
Possibly.
I don't know. Wouldn't you like to know that?
These guys don't mess around.
But that would have been pretty impressive, especially back in 1926. In 1967, Bobby Gentry releases her only hit, but boy, was it a good one.
And it happens to be Ruth Ann's favorite song, she told me one day.
Really?
Yeah.
Enjoy, Ruth Ann.
This is her song.
And then she said, I got some news this morning from Choctaw Ridge. Today, Billy Joe McAllister jumped off the Tallahatchie Bridge.
Bridge. She just got that in there. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she's good. I did a show, and one of the songs that we did was that.
Oh, really?
It was a musical review, really, all country music, all women.
Yeah.
It was called Honky Tonk Angels, and it had like 24 songs in it. That was one of the songs.
Wow.
And the band did such a great job with that song. But yeah, so that was on this day in 1967. 1974, U.S. President Richard Nixon admits he withheld information about the Watergate break-in.
Good evening. President Nixon stunned the country today by admitting that he held back evidence from the House Judiciary Committee, keeping it a secret from his lawyers and not disclosing it in public statements. The news has caused a storm in Washington, and some of Mr. Nixon's most loyal supporters are calling for his resignation.
That sounds similar to some of the things that are going on in New York, calling for his resignation.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see what happens.
Yeah. Would it be? It ended the same way.
Mm.
In 1992, four officers of the Los Angeles Police Department acquitted on charges of beating Rodney King are indicted on civil rights charges.
The situation right now.
Sergeant Stacy Kuhn, Officer Tim Wind, Ted Brasino, and Lawrence Powell. Not guilty of assault.
They told me what I saw on television did not happen.
That was a mess. I mean, holy cow.
We said that in stereo.
Yeah, we did.
It was wrong.
Heartbreaking. It was on wrong. So many levels.
That's right. Yeah, sure was. Mm. In 2017, Jamaican sprint superstar Usain Bolt finishes third behind Justin Gatlin and Christian Coleman in his final individual race at the World Championship in London.
And after, I think it was Christian Coleman, literally bowed down, even though he had beat him, sort of bowed down because, you know, Usain was just so good for so long.
Oh, yeah.
And here's the end of that race.
Photo finish! It could be Gatlin as well! Usain Bolt thinks he has it. Justin Gatlin closed on Usain Bolt. Bolt, not a great start. Christian Coleman was the dominant figure.
I mean, it was a photo finish. They were all leaning forward, you know, to get their head across the finish line, and he got third on his last race. But his competition just literally paying him homage after he lost,
right?
Because he had such a great career.
Because they acknowledged
respect.
The kind of man he was, for sure. Well, we've got some feel good Olympic stories that we'll share with you later on this morning.
Some good stuff.
Really, really made me proud to be an American. I was proud of that young woman. Mm-hmm. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little bit. Birthdays today, actress Lonnie Anderson. She turned 76. Yeah. Jennifer, off of WKRP in Cincinnati.
Oh, one of the reasons I enjoyed radio so much was because of her.
Happy birthday, dear Herbie. Happy birthday to you.
Get Jennifer on that list quickly.
She was doing her imitation of Marilyn Monroe.
He loved Jennifer. See, I always thought Bailey was prettier.
Oh, yeah, the other lady. Yeah. And they always had her sort of, I don't know, dressed down to look more plain. Yeah. Compared to Lonnie Anderson,
well,
you know.
Everybody looks plain next to Lonnie Anderson. Yeah. I mean, good heavens.
But you're right. She was attractive.
Yeah. I always thought Bailey was the prettier of the two, but in a different way. Just like everybody had their favorite Charlie's Angels.
Sure.
You know.
Yep.
Mine was always Jacqueline Smith. It wasn't the blondes. And most of the guys picked the blondes.
Right.
Oh, well. What are you going to do? Here's another blonde that was very popular. You probably had a crush on her back in the day. What? Actress Maureen McCormick. She turned 65.
I only did it because I thought it was for your own good.
I know.
Did the folks punish you bad?
No. No, they didn't punish me at all.
They didn't?
Well, don't sound so disappointed.
Boy, if I'd been in their place, I would have given it to you good.
I don't know why you're knocking yourself out, Bobby. Craig can beat you with one hand tied behind his back.
She just
Marsha.
Stick it to you, and you'd go away smiling, going, "I think she just stuck it to me. I love her."
But it's Marsha, and I love her. Country singer, I really like this girl. I think she's really talented. Country singer Terry Clark. She is 53.
Well, I love to talk to you, but then I'd miss Donahue. That's right. I got better things to do.
Yep, she does.
And she did. 53 years old. Janet McTeer is having a birthday today. I love her. A lot of people don't know who she is. She turns 58. She is in one of my most favorite movies ever, The Songcatcher.
Mm-hmm.
And I just love her.
This is her doing some live acting. So you hear a little bit of a crowd in the background, but the lines that she gives are just wow.
Because when one woman strikes at the heart of another, she seldom misses. And the wound is invariably fatal.
Is that so?
Oh, I'm so convinced it's so.
And she's very believable. She could stick it to you, too.
Oh,
but you wouldn't walk away from hers.
She is, if you have not seen movies with her in it, she's really, really good. And she does such a great job. So I highly recommend watching her movies if you can. Also having a birthday today, Patrick Ewing. He turns 59.
Yep, New York.
Al has Starks for Ewing. Ewing with the spin. Ewing, yes! 1/8 seconds remaining. The Knicks lead by one. Indiana calls for time.
Made Marv Albert look good for many, many a year.
Guess so.
As the sportscaster. Patrick Ewing, 59.
We also have Born on This Day. Well, he was just a legend.
Oh, yeah.
And as far as our astronauts go, Neil Armstrong, also born on this day.
His famous words.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
I remember watching that as a kid. I mean, I was, at that point, I was 10, 11, something like that. Yeah, I had to have been 10.
Wow.
That was a big deal. That was a big deal. And still is, really. And then I had people in my family that said, we never went to the moon.
Oh, my gosh.
Not in my immediate family, but my uncles. They were also would talk about the Kennedy assassination and stuff. I was a little kid. I was like, what are they talking about? They're very angry right now.
Oh, my goodness.
Anyway. Yeah.
They really, really didn't think?
My one uncle didn't believe, yeah. He said it was a setup.
All righty.
Yeah. And if you believe that, then watch the movie Capricorn. It's maybe one of O.J. Simpson's best movies that he was in. He was one of the astronauts. Capricorn 1. It's a good movie. It was like the first movie I'd ever watched. Like, I go, I didn't believe, you know, the conclusion, but it made me think for the first time, could our government actually orchestrate something that's not true?
Mm.
And then I saw Wag the tail. What was the name of the movie?
Wag the Dog.
Yeah, Wag the Dog. And I go, wow, that's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway,
yeah, that is interesting.
Put my tin hat away. Let's go back to our trivia question right now. There is a custom in Italy for women to wear red what for luck on New Year's Eve? Any guesses?
A lot of people have guessed lipstick. That's a great guess.
It is a good guess. I like that.
Yeah, that's a really good guess. That's not it, but it is a good guess. We'll be back with the answer when we return from this break.
It's the Morning Jam.
The Morning Jam with Janet and Mark.
Hi, I'm Sherry Brady with Apex Home Loans. With all the talk about today's low interest rates, you may have wondered whether now might be a good time for you to refinance your home loan. If so, I would love to talk with you about it and discover how I can best help you. I'll create an in-depth analysis for you, comparing your current loan to several refinance options and taking into consideration your long and short-term plans. Then I'll make recommendations to you as to what I believe the best solution would be to accomplish your goals. I have more than 20 years' experience helping people obtain the best home loan possible, and I would love to help you too. Ready to explore your options? Then visit our website at lynchburglender.com to connect with me online, or you can call or text me directly at 434-238-8984. Again, that's online at lynchburglender.com, or call or text me at 434-238-8984.
Sherry Brady, NMLS ID 217258, Apex Home Loans, NMLS ID 2884, NMLSConsumerAccess.org.
Looking for some great food and good times? InsaneRadioDeals.com has the deal for you. $50 trio Brick Oven Eatery gift cards for only $37.50. That's right, $50 gift card to Trio Brick Oven Eatery for only $37.50. With their menu of made-from-scratch pizza with fresh ingredients, signature wings, and much more. A $50 gift card to Trio Brick Oven Eatery in Forest for only $37.50. This deal and many more at InsaneRadioDeals.com.
Step into the fast lane Monday through Friday afternoons from 5 to 6 as we talk tech, UVA, Liberty, and more. So join us on the CBS Sports Radio Lynchburg app. Ask Alexa and Google Home stream CBS Sports Radio Lynchburg. And of course, 93.3 FM, 1320 AM Lynchburg.
Oh, you're gonna take me home tonight. Oh, down beside that red firelight. Oh.
Morning Jam.
To make the rockin' world go round.
Yeah, I sent that to Steve, our voice guy.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you know, I get to play with the audio.
Right.
This is something I did with his voice. And he goes, man, dude, that is awesome. I said, you're part of Queen now. You can go to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame now.
And even though you can't sing, it doesn't matter.
That's right. 'Cause
you made it work. Hey, our Mind Jam trivia, it was a fun one this morning.
Yeah, this is a custom in Italy for women to wear red what? For luck on New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
I'm just, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And the answer was, there is a custom in Italy that women wear red lingerie on New Year's Eve.
Okay.
Because it will bring them luck.
Interesting.
And it probably would with their fella.
Yeah, well.
Maybe.
I'm just wondering.
Maybe you like red, you know.
I'm just wondering, you know, I don't know if in Italy they do like here. Things are brought back, you know, right after Christmas. So you have a very small window. Like, hey, I'm going to wait for people to bring back the red, you know, lingerie they didn't like. Hurry up and get it before New Year's Eve at a discount. See, I'm thinking in discount form.
Of course,
this
you
is
are.
What my mom would teach me to do, and Dave Ramsey, of course. So I'm gonna get discounted lingerie because I'm not gonna pay full price.
The reason we went there is because today is National Underwear Day.
Oh, it is.
It is.
Oh,
it's National Underwear Day. Yeah. Here's some underwear facts for you.
Okay, good.
When it comes to men, only 10% prefer to wear boxers, and on behalf of women everywhere, I'm thankful for that little tidbit. 25% like tight boxers. I'm a boxer brief kind of girl myself.
Okay.
And 40% are keen on slips. I don't know what that even means. What does that mean? What is a slip?
I've never worn one, so I couldn't tell you.
Is that like, I don't, tidy whiteys? I don't know.
Well, no.
I don't know what
because... Well, that was one of the first things that went when I got married.
For the tidy whities?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
None of those.
Yep.
All right. On average, American girls have 21 lingerie sets.
Wow.
And hides a couple for special occasions in her closet.
Okay.
I'd say that's probably
about right.
Yeah. I would say so.
Okay.
But, some of us have more of a appreciation than that than others, I would say.
Okay.
Well, some people don't want to invest in.
No,
some people don't want to invest in things that you don't see.
Right.
Well, and then other.
That would make sense.
With Victoria's Secret numbers tanking like they have been, that may be a current trend.
Speaking of which,
they're not really going there.
One of Vicky's girls got the bronze. We were a little
whatever
shaken by that.
Mm. I don't know. Whatever. Also, one more fact.
Okay.
Since it's National Underwear Day.
Yes.
Women started wearing underwear much later than men.
Really?
18th century. See, I don't really want to know too much about that information.
No, I don't either.
There's some things I don't want to... Because my cousin and I had this conversation. We're like, oh, we were born in the wrong time. We should have been born in a... No, we shouldn't have. We would have been terrible. Living back then, we'd have constantly been whining about our hair.
Right.
That you didn't have the hair care products. You didn't have the skin care products. Uh-huh. Apparently, you didn't have underwear. No, I was born exactly in exactly the right time. All right. So I got some texts this morning.
Yeah.
About our Olympians.
Okay.
And they were talking about said several Patriots won medals yesterday.
Yes.
They mentioned the woman wrestler. What an amazing young woman she is. Mm-hmm. So we're pretty excited about Tamira Mensah-Stock.
Yeah.
Isn't that is that how you say her
name? I think that's it, yeah.
Yeah.
She wrapped herself in the flag, just singing the praises of being part of this country.
And how much she loves America.
Mm-hmm.
I love representing the U.S. I freaking love living here.
Yeah.
She said. And she just wrapped herself in the flag and was just so thankful and beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
It was a beautiful thing to see. And so I hope that everybody enjoyed that moment as much as I did. I just thought it was fantastic. To see that. Wasn't too excited about the soccer ladies winning.
Well, we got
spoiler
alert that looks like just the blurb that came across that American women's soccer team got the bronze. Yeah.
Boo.
It's just so odd. I've
even
heard
spent more time with my Megan Rapinoe voodoo doll yesterday.
Well, it is still hanging up here in the studio. I'm just curious. We've got a few seconds. I wonder who came across and first bit the gold, your medal. It's got a picture of somebody biting. It's just sort of this tradition where they bite the gold.
I don't think I knew that.
Yeah. I want
to,
because
I'm checking to see if
Underdog,
real.
Remember Underdog in the commercial or the lead up to the show starting, he would bite into like a coin.
I know
coin
people to used to do that to make sure they were real, but
they
I
were
don't,
like
I didn't
a
know
wooden
they did
nickel.
It, didn't know that they did it with.
Yeah.
Olympic medals. I mean, golly.
Yeah.
Want to make sure it wasn't that candy wrapped up in foil.
CBS News Brief. Health officials in Texas are sounding the alarm over the surging number of new COVID cases. The Houston Health Authority's Dr. David Peirce.
This virus is so extremely contagious. Your chances of getting through this without having become either vaccinated or infected is essentially zero.
Florida hospitals are dealing with their biggest COVID caseload since the pandemic began, and schools there are about to open. In Northern California, Dixie Fire has exploded in size, forcing thousands of people from their homes. Flames have destroyed the historic town of Greenville. Target says it'll foot the bill for employees to go to college. CBS's Elise Preston has details.
Following Walmart's lead, it's offering free college tuition to its 340,000 U.S. employees. Both bachelor's and associate's degree programs are available, with most of the coursework being done online.
CBS News Brief. I'm Deborah Rodriguez.
Good morning. This is Kimberly McBroom in the WDBJ 7 Newsroom with your Virginia Talk Radio Network news update. We're learning new details about embezzlement charges against Roanoke City Councilman Robert Jeffrey Jr. The document says Jeffrey's government-issued iPad was seized, but it was remotely wiped clean of all data. A jury trial for Jeffrey is set for October. Rockbridge County Public Schools announced two athletes have tested positive for COVID. After contact tracing was done, 20 athletes have been told to quarantine. Allegheny County Schools also announced a positive COVID case among its athletes, causing them to delay football practices at the high school until August 14th. And Montgomery County Public Schools is the first district in the New River Valley to vote for universal masking. MCPS will start the school year by requiring students to wear masks while indoors. I'm Kimberly McBroom. Join me for WDBJ 7 Morning from 4:30 until 7 every weekday morning. And join us from 7 to 9 on WZBJ 24.
Hello, Americans. I'm Todd Stern. Stand by for news and commentary next. Are you looking for a university that provides a quality Christian education with excellent academic and athletic programs? Well, I want to invite you to visit Liberty University, where they offer multiple visiting opportunities to fit your schedule. Plan a visit to their Central Virginia campus and stay for an afternoon, a day, or an entire weekend. You can also take a virtual tour from the comfort of your own home. Plan your visit today by texting GOVISIT to the number 49596. Again, that's GOVISIT to the number 49596. Most Democrats want the government to force Americans to mask up. That's according to a new survey from Rasmussen Reports. 66% of Democrats want mandates even for those who are vaccinated. Republicans, on the other hand, are overwhelmingly opposed to the mandates. Dr. Jeff Warren is a member of the Memphis City Council. He is also a progressive Democrat. Dr. Warren has been among the most vocal critics of those who refuse to get a vaccine. Not only has he been vaccinated, but Dr. Warren makes it a point to tell anyone who will listen that he wears two face coverings. So it was something of a surprise when he announced the other day that he had contracted the China virus. It does make you wonder whether the vaccine or the masks will actually keep you safe. My new book now topping the charts. You can order a copy of our Daily Biscuit right now at your favorite bookstore or online at toddstearns.com.
Your morning jam weather forecast from WDBJ 7.
Hi, meteorologist Brent Wyatt. Skies are partly to mostly sunny today. Highs at 86 degrees. Look for a low of 64 under clear skies. A hot day on Friday, though. Highs around 90 degrees with a low of 66. And as we head into Saturday, a slight chance of showers and storms, otherwise daytime highs in the mid-80s. Look for more heat and humidity Sunday, highs in the low 90s.
And currently, it's kind of chilly. I don't want to say chilly. That may be extreme. But pretty cool, 59 degrees in Appomattox, 61 in Salem, and Roanoke, 61 in Bedford and in Lynchburg.
I don't know if you noticed, it wasn't like super cold in the studio this morning. Like, I mean, maybe it's because of the weather and where the temperature is set. Because it's not in our room. It's in the room
right,
next door.
Right.
So it's like not as frigid this morning. So I'm digging that.
Interesting. Yeah, it's good. Appalachian Power is saying that they're going to be conducting a required test of its electricity generating units at the Leesville Dam near Alta Vista. The tests will be performed starting around 9 p.m. this evening and will continue through tomorrow morning. Testing will increase downstream flows at locations on the Roanoke River, local locally known as the Stanton River, depending on the distance from the dam. Locations close to the dam, for example, around the Alta Vista area, can expect to see a slow and total increase in river evaluation to around 8 feet, with a peak planned between 5 and 7 a.m. on Friday. So just know that this is going to be going on, not expected to create downstream hazards, but the company urges all recreational and commercial users of the river and shoreline to be aware of higher levels and faster water flows. So just be aware of that.
Yep. GoFest is only a few months away from welcoming thousands of people to the Roanoke Valley, and organizers are making some major changes to the annual Outdoor Fest. The event, which is typically held at the River's Edge Park, will now be moving to downtown Roanoke this year. It'll just help make it easier for the businesses to make it all the beloved outdoor activities work downtown. Organizers will be closing off the streets. The weekend of the event is October the 15th through the 17th. Franklin Road will be closed, as well as other parts of downtown, in order to make room for the activities like bike riding, rock climbing, and many, many other things that they do. This sounds like something really fun to do. If you want to check it out, again, set aside these dates on your calendar, October the 15th through the 17th, and that is GoFest in Roanoke.
Nice. Well, this is a sad day, I think, for Lynchburg. The Exchange Club of Lynchburg, a community service group, is discontinuing its Pancake Jamboree fundraiser. The very first, probably.
They're not just this year.
It's
done.
That's what they say.
Wow.
It was first held in 1959.
Okay.
After 60 years, the club stated they have decided to discontinue the event without going into specific details as to why. It says, it is with great sadness that we have made the decision to discontinue this fundraiser for a number of logistical reasons. Mm-hmm. The Exchange Club would like to thank the community and businesses for their unwavering support of our event over the many years. That is Michael Staley, the president of the Exchange Club. That's what was said in a statement.
Wow.
The club will hold a raffle fundraiser in replace of the Pancake Jamboree. Tickets will be sold from September through the end of October. Each ticket will be $50. Well, darn.
Well, there's so many elements here for me personally. I got to work it, and I didn't ever get to flip the pancakes, and I think you did a few times.
I flipped the pancakes more than once.
Yeah, I did a radio remote from there, but more importantly, me and a bunch of other guys would meet every year down there.
Oh, yeah.
At 6:30. And we'd have breakfast, and then we'd all go off. And I mean, we've been doing it for about 15 years. So it was one time I knew we would all be together.
That's right.
And then you'd get to meet celebrities on both sides, left and right.
Mm-hmm.
You'd see the local news people, the mayor, whoever.
Yeah.
It was their way to...
People. I mean, it was just, yeah.
And then sometimes you got to see people just waiting in line. You're there eating your pancakes,
right.
And here you go. There's Tom Gurdy. I haven't seen him since last year.
Exactly.
I mean, it was that kind of thing. It was neat.
And it's going to be sad.
Yeah.
To see it go.
And it went all day. You could literally go have breakfast, lunch,
that's right,
and dinner. I think they finished maybe up at 7 p.m.
Something like that.
And talking about the logistical, my old radio boss, and we both know Jerry Edwards, he was the president of the Exchange Club for a number of years. And so I got a little bit of an insight from actually his son, Mark, on how big of a deal it is to unload those tractor trailers with the gas grills. And they would get students from the local colleges would come in. And
mm-hmm.
because primarily it was as older gentlemen, you know, that are part of the leadership. And they get all these young bucks in there.
I wonder if that's part of the reason that, you know, that it's not happening anymore.
Yeah.
And we're seeing this happen with a lot of things, like the Jewish Food Festival.
Right.
You know, that congregation's getting older.
Right.
And that was such a magnificent thing.
Hmm.
And they're saying, it's getting harder and harder because the younger people aren't, if they don't step in and start doing these events, then they're not going to happen.
Yeah, they're not going to continue.
So, but they didn't go into any specifics as to why they're not continuing to do it. But I will say, Lynchburg will be all the poorer for not having
it. Yeah, it was such a great event.
It was good.
It's the first Tuesday every year, wasn't it?
They fed more than just bellies.
Right. You know, exactly.
It was, I don't know.
And the Exchange Club is a really great organization helping kids and stuff.
Yeah. And I mean, I hope this raffle will do well for them, but it's not the same.
Yeah.
But there you go.
Man, my pancakes and sausage is going away.
I know. It's so sad, but true.
Yeah.
Hey, at least yesterday we did, you know, you're not eating as well today because yesterday was Kaylee's last day.
Yeah. And we had quiche and... There is some cake over there. I can't believe there's still cake.
There's cake left, but as far as your...
I thought the interns that work with Ed, you know, and Trey
would
were going to
finish
it
that.
Up, and they didn't.
Maybe it's not sweet enough for them.
Well.
It's pretty...
That was a good cake, though. I mean, it just had enough sweetness.
Well, it was... It's a strawberry cream cake, which is Kaylee's... was her favorite cake, so that's why.
Can we go to cake for a minute since we're there?
Sure.
Because you and I have done a lot of weddings. A couple together.
Mm-hmm.
I have had the chance to eat cake on occasion, mm-hmm. you know, 15-20 times a year because I was doing that many
weddings. I am a wedding cake snob.
Well, I become one because you get to taste a lot of cakes. And I'm going to tell you what, some of the cakes I've had over the years, I mean, the icing was Crisco oil with a little bit of sugar. And it's like, yeah.
Have you? So I
prefer a low to medium sweetness on my icing. It just.
So do you ask how long before you started asking who did the cake?
Well, see, sometimes I'm setting up while the cake's being put in place, so I get to see.
That was one of the first questions that we would ask.
Oh, okay. Who's doing the cake?
Who's doing the cake?
Yeah.
And then sometimes if it was like a family member or something mm-hmm. was doing it.
Right.
One time I had I had him bring a cake in and it was tiny.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, please tell me there's a sheet cake in the back.
Right.
Because there was no way it wasn't going to happen. And if it's the only dessert you have, people get grumpy they don't have their cake.
How do you feel about cupcakes?
I'm not a fan.
Okay. I'm not either because I think I'd rather have a piece of cake from a sheet cake than the cupcake. The cupcakes tend to be dry. I mean, not all of them.
Right.
But they tend to be. And when you're getting it from a sheet cake, the chances of it being
well,
more fresh,
I would rather
it seems.
I would rather see like a little tear and then do a sheet cake in the back. But I told the girl that was running the things in the back, I said, y'all better hope this cake is terrible and people aren't going to eat it. And it was, so it was fine.
So,
but
that was one time you were actually happy the cake was not.
That you're so happy that it's not good because you knew there was going to be plenty because nobody was going to eat it. So,
I'm just wondering, and this is the last thing about cake, and it's not about the taste of the cake, but when I meet with brides, I try to tell them, look, you've asked your guests to invest a whole day in your special day.
Mm-hmm.
So be aware that it's for you, and you're primarily talking to the bride here. But remember your guests.
Right.
And I tell them when I meet with them, the placing of the cake is important. I tend to use it for a breakup of the first music set. I like to go and then, because I say people stay for cake, you will see 15% of the people leave after the cake is, because they want to stay for cake.
Really?
And okay. And that's been my experience. People stay for the cake. They may not dance, but I'll be darned if they don't want to taste that cake, and then they're gone. And it's usually the older crowd.
You don't think it breaks it brings the party down to stop the music and then go do the cake?
I tend to run it hard for 30-35 minutes, and they typically are gasping anyways because we've played a lot of hot rotation stuff. Now, some people do the cake. Some people do the cake right out of the toast and everything. And there's plenty of venues that I work for. They've got a schedule, and I live by their schedule.
Right.
I have a tendency
to want to go ahead
and get
do
it done.
That. But just because sometimes not all DJs are good at keeping everything going.
Right.
And then the party just goes.
Yeah,
after that.
Oh my gosh! Hey, I can tell you this. I've seen plenty of people come up and ask for a song, and I say, "Now you're going to dance to it, right?" Oh yeah! And then I play it because it's a medium mm-hmm. kind of song that I don't think, and the dance floor clears, and they're nowhere to be found. So I've learned over the years. No, if it doesn't fit, we ain't playing it.
That's right.
So there
That's
you go.
That's exactly right.
It's time for Janet's Five and Dine on the Morning Jam. Give her 5 minutes and she'll give you some great inspiration for a delicious meal tonight.
Five and Dine brought to you by our friends at F&L Market. Boy, they've got some great specials coming up this week. We'll share those with you in just a second. They're on Memorial Avenue in Lynchburg, and they are locally owned, family owned. They're an independent grocery store. And go by and see Todd and the crew today and thank them for helping us bring you Five and Dine. Well, I've got a recipe today using that zucchini up. It is plentiful. It is everywhere. You can use zucchini or yellow squash in this chicken zucchini casserole recipe. You're going to preheat your oven to 350 degrees. And then in a large bowl, you're going to prepare your topping. Your topping is going to be like a stuffing, like you could use a stovetop or a Pepperidge Farm, something like that. You're going to make that and set aside half a cup of that mixture for the topping. Then you're going to take 4 zucchini that you've diced, your cooked chicken, 3 boneless, skinless chicken breasts, cooked and diced, and a cream of chicken soup, your onion that you've diced, and some sour cream. And you're going to mix that to some of the stuffing in a large bowl. Spread that mixture in an even layer in a 9 by 13 inch glass pan sprayed with nonstick cooking spray, and then sprinkle the reserve stuffing mix on top and bake it uncovered for about 40 minutes until it's cooked through and the top is golden brown. This also reheats very nicely, and it kind of gives you a different flavor to use up some of that zucchini that you may be seeing a lot of right now. You want to see the recipe? Go to Facebook, type in Janet's Five and Dine. You'll see this and all the recipes that we share here on the show, and it's brought to you by F&L Market, where their meat are a cut above.
Before you fire up the coffee maker, turn on the Morning Jam with Janet and Mark on the Virginia Talk Radio Network.
I come from a long line of Southern cooks, and one thing my mama always told me was ingredients matter. That's why I trust the experienced butchers at F&L Market, Lynchburg's only locally and family-owned independent grocery store. Their staff cuts and grinds fresh meats daily and will offer you the personal service you desire for everyday meals or special occasions. This week at F&L Market, keep that summertime grilling going with family pack ground beef, $2.79 a pound. Family pack ribeye steaks are $9.99 a pound. Save on Philly Gourmet Angus beef patties for $5.99 for a 24-ounce pack. Large size Sweet Baby Ray's barbecue sauce is 2 for $4. Sweeten things up with Duncan Hines cake mix, just 99 cents. Stop by F&L Market today, 2517 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. Their meat is a cut above.
Steve Christ, owner of WW Novelty Sporting Goods, is joining us. He is another, I guess we could say, satisfied customer of Steve Roberts, Mr. Meticulous with Executive Maintenance. Steve, thank you for taking a moment to talk with us today about pressure washing and what Executive Maintenance was able to do. Seems like they transformed and made the front-facing part of your building look as presentable as possible.
Oh, yeah, they did a real good job out there. It looks a lot better, and they were in here and out. We never saw them. They worked after hours. Just did a super job for us.
How important for you as a business was it that Executive Maintenance came in, they pressure washed the bricks, they pressure washed the front siding, the entire front of WW Novelties, and did it in after hours, so it allowed your business to keep going the way you want it to?
Oh, yeah. Like I say, we never missed a beat. Just made a huge difference out there when you pull up, and a lot better than I thought it was. It really, when we came in Monday morning, I was like, good grief, this really looks good.
So you mentioned it looks good in front of WW Novelties after the pressure washing work from Executive Maintenance. You mentioned the fact he was able to do it and after hours. Trustworthiness, is it reasonable to say that trustworthiness and even more so attention to detail are part of what Executive Maintenance and Steve Roberts bring?
I've known Steve for many years. He's done a lot of stuff for us. Trustworthy, it just goes without saying. He's as good as it gets.
Steve Christ, owner of WW Novelty Sporting Goods, talking about Executive Maintenance and Mr. Meticulous Steve Roberts. For more on what Executive Maintenance can do for you and your business, including pressure washing with the 250-gallon water tank, call Executive Maintenance at 434-610-1634.
When you're working on the job or around the house, you need work boots that are tough. Work boots that endure the elements and challenges while keeping your feet feeling good. So try them on at Any Day Outfitters. Hi, I'm Jake with Any Day Outfitters in the Tower Shopping Center here in Roanoke. Come try on most every major work boot brand at Any Day Outfitters, including Ariat, Wolverine, Timberland Pro, and Carolina. Anaday Outfitters, great prices, the biggest selection, and premium service. Anaday Outfitters, Tower Shopping Center in Roanoke.
The Morning Jam with Janet Rose and Mark Lamb.
Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice carried in the rhythm of the wind to call me out. You would cross an ocean.
Nice. Yeah. You know, the first time my wife heard that song, of course, she is the lyricist of our house. She gets all the lyrics.
Wrong.
That's yes. Right. And she thought it said one thing. And it was funny because the DJs on the particular station she heard that song said, you know, everybody's getting this lyric wrong, including us. And the consensus among the DJs before they looked at the lyrics is they thought they were saying dry rub.
What? So,
yes, that was the DJs. You're dry rub. Mm. And then my wife said.
Barbecue lovers.
She said, no. It's not dry rub. It's dry bones. Now, how you get dry bones out of that, I don't know. But,
don't ever take lyric advice from your wife, ever. I love Kara.
But I have to give it to her. I mean, she was just as close as the DJs were. But Jireh, it means provider. God is our provider.
Right.
So it's a great song.
Not dry rub.
Not dry rubber. Not dry bones, for that matter.
Oh, goodness.
But anyways, it's 6:53 on a Thursday where, you know, yesterday was Kaylee's last day, and we sent her off, and... she was going to head home for a few days and then head to Tennessee. So keep her in your prayers.
Yeah.
And
sweet girl.
Yeah. So we're excited to have her when we did.
Another sweet girl representing USA.
Mm-hmm.
And I just love her. Tamara Mensa Stock.
Yeah.
Olympic gold medalist wrestler.
Yep.
She began wrestling in the 10th grade.
Wow.
In Katy, Texas.
Wow.
And she was just asked a simple question by a reporter, and they said, how does it feel to represent your country like this? And she most genuinely said, I love representing the U.S. I freaking love living there. As she pumped her fist, smiled, and pulled the stars and stripes tighter to her body.
Yeah.
And she's just a sweet girl.
Yeah. It's just so simple that you're representing your country and be proud. Everybody else pretty much is doing that in every other country.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the country that everybody wants to seem to flock to. But yet, you know, we've heard enough of the negative stories. This is a good one.
She said, when I first started wrestling, I wanted to be an emblem, a light to younger women, mm-hmm. and show them you can be silly, you can have fun, and you can be strong.
Right.
You can be tough. You can be a wrestler. You don't have to be like this. I'm going to be mean to you.
Right. She's got a beautiful smile. And I don't know. We talked about it off the air, I believe. She's from the Chicago. Or you talked about Texas, but I think now they live in Chicago.
Her smile, love of country, and positive nature have captured the attention of citizens who've been beaten over the head by social justice warriors who have sucked the fun out of the games.
Oh, isn't that the truth?
That's what this article says.
Yeah.
When asked what she plans to do with the money that comes with winning a gold medal, she said she knew exactly what she was going to do with the cash. I wanted to give my mom... $30,000 so she can get a food truck because it's her dream.
Hmm.
I told her 5 years ago, all right, mommy, I'll get your food truck, but you got to be responsible.
Mm-hmm.
So my mom is getting her food truck.
Wow.
She's going to have her little cooking business. She can cook really, really, really well. Barbecue.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So there you
cool.
have it. What a great story.
I love that.
Out of Tokyo.
Yeah.
We need some more of those stories.
Yeah, we need. I mean... Yeah,
she's representing the country. She is representing it
mm-hmm.
well,
mm-hmm.
and it is heartwarming to see.
Yeah, yeah, some good stuff coming out of, like you said, the Olympics. A lot of good stories, and even some of the ones of winners, you know, from other countries. They just the adversity that they've pushed through to, to make it. We were talking about earlier going into the break about who, and I haven't looked it up yet, so I don't know. I would be curious if one of our listeners would check into that. Who's maybe the first one to bite into their gold medal to make sure it was like solid and for real and all that kind of thing. But we have a picture of one of the young ladies from one of the other countries biting into her gold. And we went into break and you said, because you remember the candies we used to get?
Oh,
yeah. You know, wrapped in gold like right. that. Just make sure it's not like, that's not yeah. candy, is it?
Like, this is even real. although when we were kids, we would get excited.
Oh, I'd rather have the candy as a kid.
That's right.
We would even
do our own little Olympics.
Oh, Olympics? Thing.
Yeah, and,
okay,
we would put that on a ribbon. That's
yeah.
why that came.
Did you compete in?
We jumped. This is one of those things where it's a miracle that any of us lived through right. our childhood because okay. when you grew up in the late 70s, 80s, you know, you did dumb stuff.
You didn't wear helmets
riding bikes
or anything.
And
yeah.
my daddy, I told you, was a mechanic.
Mm-hmm.
And so we had access to great ramps.
And tools. Power yeah. tools.
And we would like see who could jump their bike the furthest.
Right,
and,
right, sure.
You know, things like that.
Yeah.
Hit a ball the furthest. And,
yeah.
you know, that's the kind of stuff we would do. And
okay.
run. We'd do the running and that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Hey, did you see the story where the relay team was getting beat up?
Oh, by Carl Lewis, I think you mentioned. Yeah, I didn't.
Oh, wow.
But I heard you talking about it when we first, you know,
yeah.
got here this morning.
Yeah, he was at home watching the relay race,
mm-hmm.
and he was slamming Team USA for their messy handoff.
Oh.
And it
slowed it down.
Olympic legend Carl Lewis blasted Team USA men's relay team after a messy 100-meter baton exchange.
Mm-hmm.
U.S. sprinter Ronnie Baker tried to grab the baton on the first exchange, but got a handful of Fred Curley's uniform instead.
Lewis, that could be awkward.
Lewis, an 8-time Olympic gold medalist, did not mince words expressing his frustration. This is what he said on Twitter. The Team USA did everything wrong in the men's relay. The passing system's wrong. Athletes running the wrong legs. It was clear that there was no leadership. It's a total embarrassment.
Wow.
And completely unacceptable for a USA team to look worse than the AAU kids I saw.
Wow.
Darn.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know, I can't, you know, pull the next guy along with his shorts. I mean, that doesn't... You know, it's not qualifying.
That's so bad.
Yeah.
I always found it very nerve-wracking because we would have the games in high school where you would have to, you know, we would have field day or
yeah,
whatever.
Sure.
I always found passing the baton pretty nerve-wracking.
Yeah. I'd rather do the swim relay. I mean, that's pretty easy. You can visually see what's going on. You know, the baton is a total kind of a trust and timing thing that the guy's going to, you know, place it and you're going to, you know, grab it and go. Grab and go.
Yeah.
Kind of like going to
Aldi's. Was partly why the U.S. finished in sixth place
wow.
in the qualifying round and failed at a chance to medal. Curley, one of the racers, said, "We just didn't get the job done today."
Yeah.
And they were all beating themselves up pretty good.
Yeah.
But none more than Carl Lewis. So there you go. Tough love.
Yeah. 6:59. We're going to have CBS News coming up and then some more of the Morning Jam. Hopefully you can stick around.